Well, you watch this man, Mr. Doug Chafee, who's Fullerton's mayor, who wants to be a county supervisor, literally ignore his wife as she's talking at the council meeting during public comments. He totally ignores everything she says. And this woman, her name is Paulette Marshall, she's running for office for Fullerton City Council using a fake address. But what's more important here is watch this man try to close public comment as I'm walking up to the podium. I've been standing against the wall for close to an hour waiting for my turn.
Thank you. All right, we're going to close the public comments and bring it back to
you got 3 minutes.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't see you standing.
It's amazing you don't even pay attention to your wife when she's talking, Mr. Mayor.
Well, an artful thing, actually. So.
Oh, that's great. And I understand she's running for office in an address that she apparently doesn't live at, and that's a whole other discussion. My name's Joan Briano. I'm the Fullerton Informer. For those of you who don't know, I've taken a brief vacation from this circus for good reason. And it looks like things have gotten a lot worse since I've been gone, and it's nice to see people coming out here. Not everybody in this town is asleep. But I will tell you that the problems we have stem from the fact that I believe that the city is run by a bunch of crooks and a bunch of incompetent people. And the fact of the matter is there's plenty of places to put these homeless people. There's plenty of commercial real estate that's vacant all over the place. But this city council and these establishment hacks that continue to wander the halls of all these happy parties keep figuring out ways to run businesses out of town and make sweetheart deals with nonprofits and build monstrosities to create more unemployment and urbanize this place to make it more of a magnet for heroin needles, for crime, for congestion. And they hide behind the $100 million that's missing from the city coffers that should have gone into our road repair as a result of everybody looking at this big disastrous red herring that the police department had a good hand in creating, and that's when they murdered Kelly Thomas. Now, what is the solution here? Well, the solution is you don't stick these people where people have kids and families and moms home during the day, because if these people are homeless, they got several choices. They can get up in the morning and go look for work and stand in the Home Depot parking lot with all the other people that are looking for work. And this is a sanctuary city, so that involves illegal aliens and drug addicts are all hireable now in this town. The fact of the matter is you want to make deals with your pals that are making a whole bunch of money, float bonds, and all kinds of financing, and run people out of business. And I know that place on Raymond and Orchard. I knew the guy that owned the shop over there. You guys ran him out of town and outbid him with my tax money when he wanted to get financing and buy that property and expand and turn it into a body shop and a mechanic shop to hire more people and keep people working in this town. And what you've done is you've built a purple elephant, a white elephant, a pink elephant with my tax money in combination with a nonprofit to put the word out on the streets that this is a place to come for the freebies. Folks, if you can't afford a place to live, go live somewhere where you can. If you are on drugs, get help. The churches need to step up. Grace Ministries is a gigantic cash register. They got tens or if not hundreds of millions of dollars that could help solve this problem. Maybe they could open up that grand paradise that they occupy over there and turn that into a homeless camp instead of sticking it in people's neighborhoods. Yes. Things need to change in this community. And the problem is half the people in this community keep reelecting you guys. And nothing changes. And like Mr. Silva, you make these promises you're going to fix the roads. Sometimes I wonder if you're even paying attention. We've got a city attorney that's asleep half the time. How much are we paying for him? We have a police chief that walked out of here during all of the public comment. Unacceptable, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
All right. All right, that was our last speaker. We're going to bring it back to council for...